today I'm going to be reviewing the Pong Kit. What you're seeing now is a preview of the gameplay. It's Pong. I mean, there's not much I can really say about that. And it works well, and it works great. It does have a brightness switch if you have to modify it. It is in black and white, and from what I can tell, it's just crisp blocks. Like any kit, it does have a couple downsides. One being, I don't know anybody that may remember the original Pong kits during the 70s and 80s, they used to have knobs. This uses buttons rather than knobs, so it's not as retro as some may think. Also, it doesn't have a power switch, so unless you add a power switch, which shouldn't be too difficult, you do have to pull the batteries or you have to wait for it to auto power down, which is, I think, about 10 to 15 minutes. Also, it's batteries only, so it doesn't come with an AC to DC adapter, which also, I mean, for you enthusiasts out there, it's not that difficult to modify to do those things, but I wouldn't recommend those things for the beginner. But as a standalone kit, it's great for beginners, whether it's a child or an older person that just wants to learn how to get into soldering. It's only $20, so if you break it, it's not a huge deal. I don't know if any of you can see, but this was something I did a couple of years ago when I was first just getting into soldering, and my points aren't perfect, and it still ended up working just fine. It's got multiplayer mode and single player mode. It works on just about any TV because it does have just the standard red, white, yellow plug, but it just uses the yellow for the video and the white for the audio. It takes between 1 to 2 hours to complete. Obviously, it may take you a little longer if you're just starting out. The only real requirements are 3 AA batteries, a soldering iron, soldering gun, and solder. And that's pretty much it. That's all I have to say about it.